Hi friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will be understanding logistics management and in that very important area called as packaging. These are all the subheadings we are going to cover: understanding the requirements, packaging design, packaging validation, and then label design and development. In understanding the requirements, we need to capture the right requirements from the customer and related stakeholders. We need to clarify the requirements. Then we need to provide the internal communication, do the feasibility, and then provide an acceptance. For some reason, if we are having some kind of confusion, we need to again go back to the step called as clarification. And then if it is really required, we need to change the specification, and then all these steps will happen. Finally, we have to give the right feasible packaging acceptance to our customer. From the design point of view, we need to be very clear this particular packaging, in which application they are going to use it. What will be the environment condition? Whether it is going to travel in the sea, air, road, or rail. Then specification, we need to be also clear from FMEA point of view. FMEA means to say failure modes effects analysis, where we will be understanding the potential failures that can happen from this packaging, and we need to take sufficient corrective actions before itself. We need to do the validation also. In validation, there are testing and trials. In testing, we have to do something like drop test or application simulation tests like water jet or something like that. In trials, we need to do trials like sea simulation, rail simulation, roadway simulation, and we need to get acceptance from our customer. Based on the acceptance, we can prepare the report and then we can share for our customer for the final acceptance. From the validation, if we find something across, like if there is a failure in any validation tests, we need to take proper corrective action for that. So when doing those things, then we can easily avoid that in the serial production at a later point of time, any defect will not happen. With respect to the label design, why it is important for the right identification and traceability? Why we need to have right identification and traceability is because if there is a complaint or if there is a very clear information that needs to be transmitted, then we need to identify on our packaging, on our part, or on our transport container, right kind of identification. With this, it's easily possible. But when we are having our own designs which will be applied on this particular packaging, we need to be very clear that these particular labels should not come out based on the environment conditions. Consider that we have taken a packaging and we have put a label and we have shipped it in a sea mode to a different country or continent. So based on the sea mode, we know that there is a very high humidity and these particular labels can come out. So we need to take sufficient precaution with respect to this particular label specifications when we are going to attach these things on the packaging material. Then we need to understand these particular labels. Why they are important is for the error proofing, because we can avoid the wrong part shipments. Then we need to be also very sure that these particular labels are barcode compatible, because there is no point, there are certain label designs that are available where when we do that, it will be not barcode compatibility. So these things will really cause a problem, and we need to plan this proactively before we design the complete particular packaging. So that's it in this video. Thank you so much.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.